Okay. Hello, hello, hello. We're starting soon. Just buttoning up my shirt. And finding my tennis ball. All right, I think that you can hear me. I'm gonna check this out. And man, everything just like logged me out today for whatever reason. Just like, boom, I was working and all of a sudden just like bam, 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 bam. Gmail, Notion, everything was just like logged out. This is super weird. All right, let's check if this is working. I think so. Let's say, hey. Say hey and let me know. Let me know where you're watching from. Okay. And then we can go for this one. Now you can see me properly, goodly, awesomely. All right. So let's get my Apple Pencil and my little glove. Because gloves are awesome. It means that I can slide over my iPad without getting stuck. Apple Pencils are awesome because they're like pencils rather than fingers. And fingers are not so good as pencils when it comes to drawing. Maybe if you practice, you can get pretty good. So what we're going to be doing today, what I'm going to be doing today, is working on another Dreamling. I did that last week. I've been doing them here and there for a little while. And it's quite nice to do it live because it's a fairly fixed format for me right now. Kind of know how long it's going to take. It might take an hour, it might take more, but I'm going to plan to do an hour, hour and a half of drawing here on the live stream. And we'll see what happens. I have this fish idea. This fish dreamling that I want to create today. And yeah, I do know that I'm lighthearted, I'm having fun, but man, there's been some intense things that have happened the last week or so. Earthquakes, people dying. And it's, yeah, like I don't actually know how to respond to that except for trying to carry on doing what I'm doing. And just responding and reaching out to people who are affected. Just this morning, I found out that one of my friends in the crypto world, an artist, was like at the epicenter of the earthquakes in Turkey. So, yeah, really big, huge, overwhelming kind of stuff, you know. If you're thinking about something getting stolen or you're thinking about, you know, having to go to work, you're not thinking about earthquakes and surviving, getting your loved ones out of a place. So, heavy stuff. Sorry about that, but it's just what's happening. Let's draw. I'm gonna switch to this view over here. Here's a couple of other dreamlings that I've worked on. So the idea behind these dreamlings are there are these creatures that kind of change form as they go into the doodleverse, into the realm of dreams. They're the creatures that you become when you dream. And sure, they all kind of look the same. They've got this like same kind of template. And I do use a template because they're dreamlings. It's part of the same kind of project. So this is the one that I did last week. Very like pure and innocent, almost like a priest or priestess, angelic kind of vibes, but also very priestly, priestess kind of vibes, which I really enjoyed. So, got four. And here is my template. And I think you guys can hear me. Let me know what's happening. Say hi. If you have any questions, let me know. Like, I can jump into like showing you how to animate or how to color or how to, whatever. how to do line work, anything. So I'm here to teach, not just to show you my art and stuff. But yeah, any questions you have about me, my process, about creating iPads, Procreate, Adobe Fresco, Wacom tablets, etc., etc., ask away. All right. I'm not going to use my keyboard here because I'm on the iPad. Okay. So what I have here is a bunch of different layers with a bunch of different initial ideas and sketches. So I'm going to just remove some and keep some there. You'll see that there's a fish one that I really like. And so I'm going to use that one today. And sorry if I sound a bit nasally, but yeah, it's the life of a parent. It's just been sickness after sickness after sickness. It's been crazy. Yeah, that looks good. Okay, then I can pretty much delete the rest of these things. And man, this last few weeks, days, week, the last week, I've been doing a lot of gardening. Why? Because we had to make our fence bigger, or our entry into our garden bigger. So we had to make the gate or the entryway bigger. Why? Because we got a new buck feet. And what the heck is a buck feet? Let me see. Let me see if I can actually show you what a buck feet is. Buck feet. We got this one called the Dolly buck feet. And it's an electric buck feet. It means we can go far and fast with our babe, our two-year-old babe, in the buck feet. So, Dolly buck feet. Let's check out the images here. Da-da-da. It is this one. This one. Can I zoom in or whatever? I do not know. Something like this. So we got a black frame and a gray buck. This one. So we use these things instead of cars. And it is awesome. So that's what we've been trying to fit into our yard. And because they're so long, like if there's a car parked outside of our front yard, then we can't get our buck feet in and we can't get it out. So we've had to do a bunch of pulling of bushes out and putting pavers down. Okay, shall we draw? Shall we draw? Let's draw. I'm going to fill this layer, just reduce the opacity a little bit, do a little bit of sketching on top. I've got this little 6B pencil that I love using. I put all the favorite brushes that I use inside this rad folder. There's a couple of crazy ones, and a couple of here and there ones, but this is pretty much all the brushes that I use at the moment. Maybe not even these at the bottom. Maybe just like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Maybe just 7 brushes at the moment. It's really cool. I've downloaded a bunch of True Grit texture supply brushes. That's a mouthful to say. And I'm beginning to experiment with them as well. I really sound nasally, don't I? I need to go swim in the sea. Talking about sea, this is the Dreamling that I'm going to be doing today. Maybe I can make it a little less, you know, chin-like down here. Make it a bit more like a fish. Sorry, that's like a funny way of saying fish in South Africa. Some people really do say fish or fish, something like that. Yeah. Well, I like this one, not so much the ones that go up. Right, something like that. So imagine having a dream that you're a fish. I had some really vivid dreams last night of childhood friends, and we were on holiday, and they were dressing up as mushrooms. I'm planning to get in touch with them today just to be like, hey, I dreamt of your family last night. Is everything okay? And this little fishy. It's quite nice, like not having this part of the tail. So that's a nice little discovery there. I'm really battling with this one. Let's just erase this. Start again. This is why I like to sketch. I mean, I really do like just freehand doodling, but when I have, you know, a particular thing that I'm wanting to do, it really helps to do some sketching first. There we go. Yeah. And what I normally do, instead of just rotating it, I normally just rotate my whole iPad. Which is pretty cool. But I realize you're watching this, so I'm trying not to do that. All right. I think that the eye is pretty standard. I'll just doodle that. So there's a fish. Am I going to do a head? Yeah, I think I'll do a head. Right. I like it. It's quite a big area here of something, and that's been a challenge for me in this project, is to try fill this area up with something. And so what I think I might do here is actually turn it into an island today. So this could be a fish island type thing. Something like this. Maybe a little bit of both. It's not like super 3D, not like super flat. Something like that. Some trees on it. Palm trees could be cool, but also all islands have palm trees. You could have some really interesting trees here, you know? This is a dream realm. Palm trees do exist in the dream realm, but also there's these weird trees that have eyes in them. So let's put these trees in there, you know? Maybe this can come down here, kind of be like a bush of sorts. You could have some stuff happening behind it and some stuff happening in front of it. Yeah, I like that. All right, and then there could be all kinds of other fish down here. Or, you know, some that like wrap around. Something like that. And there could be seaweed too. Seaweed could be pretty cool to draw. Yeah, and then tons of bubbles within the scene. Maybe there's another fish down here. Maybe there's a couple more too. It's a bit weird seeing that right next to the lips. So maybe we turn it this way. Yeah. So it's kind of covering the eye. Some more down here. And then also maybe a submarine. We all live in a yellow submarine, a yellow submarine, a yellow submarine. So submarines are pretty common within the Doodleverse. They do appear from time to time. And then our chair will have some stars, moons, that kind of thing. Yeah, I think that looks good. Maybe some things flying this way. Maybe a bird or two, or birdlings flying along. Yeah, two of them, three of them. Maybe. Okay. And all of these can be these like one-eyed fish that, you know, you're not quite sure whether they're backwards or forwards. If you've seen much of my Doodleverse work, maybe you'll be like, oh yeah, I know that fish. And this guy can have like one of those big eyes. Ha ha! Which is a little bit more comical than some of the stuff that I have been doing. Okay. So, I guess we can take this above here and get into some doodling with my jiggly line brush. Let's begin with the line work. That was a pretty good line. If you've watched some of my stuff before, you'd be like, wow. Sometimes it takes a really long time for me to do line work like that. Okay. Eh, voila. The lines are going good today. Yesterday I met with a friend and we were just walking in Amsterdam. It was beautiful weather. We went to a really nice cafe. Can't remember what it's called, but they had vegan everything. Croissants and chocolate brooches, which is like a pan chocolat, a croissant filled with chocolate, and almond goo and almonds on top, and ooh, it was just good. Plus really good coffee, really good. So that, plus walking, plus we went to an Algerian restaurant for lunch. It was amazing. And I was gonna tell you something related to that. Oh, I was trying to tell him about some South African adverts that were pretty good when I was growing up. And you guys should totally watch Raj 1 and Raj 2. I don't know if it's racist, it might be. But in Durban, where I'm from, there are the most Indians outside of India, anywhere else in the world. So I had Indian neighbors, Indian friends, Indian, I don't know, there were just a lot of Indian people in the place that I lived. Love them. Brilliant food, amazing. But they do not speak like Indian Indians. They speak in a very different dialect. And so there's these two people called Raj 1 and Raj 2, and this is how sometimes Indians speak. Maybe different. Maybe Raj 1 and Raj 2 just didn't speak like an Indian. I don't know. But anyway, there's these two like collage characters and they're trying to sell this kind of car called the Corsa Light, the light side of life. And so I was really trying hard to figure out who these characters were yesterday when I was meeting with my friend. But I found it last night and sent it to him. But they're really funny. It got me, you know, thinking back to South Africa and the time I spent there as a kid, as a young adult. Moved to the Netherlands when I was about 28, I think. I think that's right. Just gonna draw a perfect circle here and then base this perfect circle or the next circle on this perfect circle. So I like things being pretty round, but I don't think, or I don't like things being perfectly round. So I use the perfectly round circle to base my not so round circle on, but it is a base. So just rub this out a little bit. Well, it's a big one. A little bit. Put it in there. All right. Sweet. And I will merge down. Okay, let's draw. I'm gonna draw the body now. Maybe the body can be fishy, scaly. Scaly might be cool. Yeah. I'll draw this one on a new layer. And it will most probably have a bunch of these lines in them to make it feel like it's a fin or something like that. Maybe I'll draw another one here to feel, you know, make it feel like it is really like a double kind of fin fish thing. Fin? Something like that. All right, and at the back here, we can just do a bit of erasing. I don't know if it's a common thing in the whole world, eraser or rubbing out, or if they're mutually interchangeable everywhere. But yeah, I definitely use both of them now. I think I only use rubbing out as a kid. Maybe I started using eraser when people used to, in Photoshop, say use the eraser tool, because the rubber tool, like what's the rubber tool? What is a rubber? I know what a rubber is in South Africa, but I don't think a lot of other people did. Okay, so we've got those. I think that we can add some of these stripes onto the fins, like so. Yeah, that's looking good. And we can start making birds and fish. That's maybe where it came from, fish. South Africans have a lot of different accents. You can't just be like, oh, that's a South African accent right there. Maybe, but there are Indian, Zulu, Xhosa, like big accent groups, English, Afrikaans. And so it's just like, wow, it's crazy. There are 11 official languages. I can't remember them all. But you just start like hearing these different accents in the different parts of South Africa. And so that's why I was talking about Fish and Raj 1 and Raj 2 doing their thing, trying to sell you a Xhosa light. It's very fun. Okay. Are we going to have eyes on these? Eyeballs, I mean? I do not know. For now, we'll just have it like this. So, yeah. Let's move that a little bit there. And then we can add some of these kind of fish type things on the bird, which I've grown, you know, really fond of. It's not really working like that, is it? There we go. Sometimes you just need to like figure out the way to draw something, and then it always works. If you try to draw it backwards or start at a different place, then it does not work. All right, got another eye here. We shall see if we'll put eyeballs in a little bit later. Two of these bird things, maybe another. Maybe another. Maybe one can be like flying out the screen here. Something like that. Alrighty. Fish. Have some fun with these fish. Maybe we can do these kind of eyes for the fish. Ooh, I like that. They don't always have to be these like dream or doodleverse kind of eyes, you know? But that's just the way my eyes have been for a while. And this guy's like a moray eel. When I was a kid, I caught a moray eel under the rocks, and it was strong. My whole rod was bending. I was like, oh. I don't know if I actually reeled him in, but it may be why I'm not such a big fan of fishing now, because I caught him fair and square, but you know, he did not allow me to bring him out. Well, I hooked him. Ooh, I quite like this character. Yeah, he's cool. can see how like the birds and the fish kind of resemble each other. There's one little fishy guy down here. It's like a moonfish. Maybe we should do that. Okay, I've officially created a moonfish. There we go. You can do it, Rich. You can do the fins. Yes, I can. Yes, I can. Alrighty. More fish, more fish. That was a little bit shaky there. Okay. Okay. And today, oh my days. Oh, for the last couple of days, actually, I've been doing some generative coding in an app called Processing. I've been writing Java code. People, I've been writing Java code. This doodler artist guy has been writing Java. Java. It's pretty easy if you know what you're doing, but literally everything I do, I'm like processing how to do arrays. Because I know how to do arrays in JavaScript, but in Java, it's different, and it's very different at times. So there's all kinds of things that I'm learning. So it's been really, really interesting. But I've been doing some pretty intense kind of stuff. It's not just like images. It's like masking with alpha channels and going through all the pixels in an image and blending modes and advanced stuff. Well, anyway, I think it's pretty advanced. That is for an upcoming NFT project that I'm working on. The code name, actually not the code name, the final name is Dreamheads. And it's going to be epic. It's going to be about these people who go into the realm of dreams and they get addicted to the realm of dreams. And so in real life, they start developing clouds around their heads. They go blind. But in the dream world, their eyes get really big and wide, and they're able to help other people navigate their dreams and go between realms in the doodleverse. And so this is what the collection is about. So I'm really excited about it. So I've been doing some fun stuff with it. I've done quite a lot of the artwork already, but now I'm trying to do some fancy stuff with clouds and shadows and things like that. All using Java and processing, which I've been wanting to get into again for a number of years. And when I say again, I first used processing, kind of played around with it quite a bit when I was 19. It might be like, so how many years back is that? 16 years. That's crazy. It's absolutely crazy how long ago that is. I don't think it's changed that much, to be honest. But yeah, I've been wanting to get back into it. Haven't really found an excuse to get back into it. But now is the time. And I'm getting back into it with doodling. So not just like making flat shapes and 3D stuff. It's like random generative doodled art mixed with non-random doodle art as well. Oof, and it's been fun. Coding is like a different ball game. It's like, for me anyway, I just want to get something done. not really concerned about how neat or how performant it is or something like that. So I go into these like spiral modes. Sounds terrible. Coding modes, whatever. Like I go deep and I focus and I get it done. And then I come up and I'm like, I'm going to forget all of that. As long as I can just put something in and get something out, that's great. It's what I do with a lot of things. And so, yeah, it's been really fun. And I have a couple of ideas of what I'd like to use this coding tool for in terms of my art practice, my art journey. Yeah. Okay, we've got a couple of fish here. Ooh, I could actually do this fin here. There we go. And probably remove this. And this. And if you were here last week, you would have heard me tell you about chiropractors and the fact that I'm rolling a tennis ball underneath my feet all day, every day, if I'm sitting at a desk. And yeah, I'm feeling so much healthier since going to the chiropractor just 3 weeks ago. And I'm reading about what chiropractor practices do. It's flipping amazing. Like, people have had knee injuries that they've like not been able to get right, even though they've been for knee surgery. Like, they always feel pain. They go for a couple of chiropractor visits and boom, no more pain. No more pain in their knee. And they're just working on your spine sometimes. Sometimes your pelvis or your neck. Sometimes they stick their fingers in your mouth to like do stuff. It's weird. But yeah, very, very interesting. I would highly recommend going to see a chiropractor. A good one, because I think there can be some pretty dodgy ones and pretty weird ones. But I guess, you know, that's the same as almost everything. There's always going to be the outliers, and they're always going to be stupid or brilliant, and then a whole bunch of people in the middle. All right. Things are coming along here. Just erasing a couple of background layers in places that the fish overlap. Or vice versa. Most of the time, I'm just erasing the background layer because it's overlapping there. Mustn't go too vigorously, otherwise the whole table wobbles and it feels like the whole world wobbles. So we just want to erase gently. I keep telling my daughter that. Gentle, gentle, baby, gentle. She does not hit my face gently. She's like, quah, 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 quah. And I'm like holding her, don't want to like pull her hands out because then I'll drop her. Gentle, baby, gentle. Sometimes she listens. Sometimes. If you're watching now, Zoe, I love you. I love you, my baby. She might be watching. She might be watching Elmo or something else like that. She really likes Elmo. She really likes Peppa Pig at the moment. And I think it, you know, can change quite a lot and quite quickly. Okay. Hello, submarine. This submarine has got a lot of windows. And I want to move the windows along just a little bit over here. There we go. Oh no. I left a little bit out. Okay. There we go. Propeller time. Maybe I should do that on another layer. Just makes the next step a little bit easier. That actually looks like a butterfly. Should remember that for a future butterfly project. Okay. And then here we can do the second deck or something. And the third deck. And maybe the periscope. and the lower deck, something like that looks pretty good. Merge you down, I'll do a little bit of erasing. That was my French accent. That is probably as much French as I know. No, that's a lie. I can say bonjour, un chat noir, which is a black cat, and un chien, maybe that's a dog. Une pomme rouge, un palaveau anglais. The other one was a red apple, and that was, do you speak English? Which is always really, really helpful. Ah, Riza, bonjour. You can definitely check if my French was good there. Please rate me out of 10. Your French assessment, please. My parents and my in-laws owned a place in the south of France, 2 hours south of Toulouse, near a place called Carcassonne, in this little town called, I can't remember now. It was really cool. Great wine, great walking, close to a whole bunch of other places. It was fantastic, but I remember struggling to speak to anyone there. It was a little bit tricky. But it kind of felt like if you wanted to learn French, like that's definitely the place that you should go to learn it. Quite a few expats there, quite a few like patient French ladies at the bakery. Maybe that's where, you know, a lot of them went to retire. I don't know. Carcassonne, 7 out of 10, okay. I will try my hardest to get better at French. It is definitely one of the languages that I would like to learn in my long life. Especially now that I live in Europe, it's like, well, I speak English and a little bit of Dutch. But man, if I could go to France and speak French, that would be magic. It would just be pure magic, I tell you. Okay, let's draw another fish. Riza, tell us about your best places in France. I want to hear them. Do you drink wine? Because French are known for their wine. What else are the French known for? I know they play good football, good rugby. They have a very old, good, I don't know good, but old bureaucratic system of getting stuff done post, it's a socialist system, I guess. Yeah, Paris is beautiful. It's just like all the weird normal buildings are so fancy compared to any of the weird cool buildings in South Africa. It's like, oh, this bridge, that there's no plaque, there's no information about this bridge in Paris. There's like frills and all kinds of cool stuff on it. I don't know, it's just a bridge. In South Africa, there would be like tourists there, there would be a plaque, there would be all kinds of information about this really cool bridge. But in Paris, it's just another bridge. It's epic. I went there when I was a kid, and I was just like, I was blown away. And I went there when I was married for a couple of years, also just blown away again. So many hidden gems, yeah. Paris. I want to come there. I want to come visit Paris again. I really like this little guy here. I think we need some more of him. He's got like a really cool eye and a really like, I don't know, it looks like a bit of a hairstyle. So maybe we can put him over there. Maybe we delete this fish. Sorry, little guy. Or we undo and we move you to over here. Yeah, we'll just move you. And then this guy, how is this even gonna work? Something like that. Do you hear my sound effects, ladies and gentlemen? It was pretty funny a little while ago. Well, that looks pretty cool. A little while ago, I did some kickboxing. And the Dutch are known for their kickboxing. And I'm not a big guy, but man, there were some big dudes doing kickboxing in my kickboxing class. And they would like kick and punch these bags so hard, I thought like if they kicked a house that hard, the whole house would break down. It was scary. And I remember then like doing the bag stuff was cool. You know, like my little fist doing bam, bam, bam. And then they were like, cool, let's do some sparring. So me, I was like, okay. And I was literally making those sound effects. And the guy hit me in the face. I was like, oh, sound effects do not help here. Damn. It was very, very strange why I was making sound effects. But yeah, I stopped going to that hitboxing class because my foot was sore, not because I was getting my ass handed to me. I kind of miss it now. I often think, like, if the world, like, breaks down and, you know, like, there's just, like, Armageddon or the apocalypse or, I don't know, the end times. Whew. What is this NFT artist, web designer, UX, UI guy gonna do? I can maybe run. I used to run fast, but, like, will I be able to defend myself? I don't know how to use a gun. Like, flip. Like, am I screwed? Might be. I might be screwed. So I wanted to just do some stuff. I need to make that wavy, I think. I wanted to do some stuff that was... what? Yeah. That was not digital, you know? I wanted to get better at defending myself or... Wow. I don't know if you guys heard that, but it sounded like a clown outside. Man. Hey, James. How you doing? James Howe's music. This guy went to university with me, James Howe. Wow. It is good to have you on the stream. And having Reza and James in the same room with me at the same time in real life would just be, it would be epic. So James, maybe you can come to Barcelona and we can go to this Avalanche conference together with Reza, since we're all in Europe, and then we can have a beer together or a coffee, something like that. That would be grand. I think the conversation would be very, very good. Okay, are there too many fish? I don't know. I feel like adding a couple more, maybe behind here. So yesterday I found an illustrator that had a very similar style, but yeah, maybe more of this kind of a style. I reached out to him. He was in Amsterdam and his book was in this Algerian restaurant that we went to. So I really hope he reaches back out to me. Be really cool to meet some illustrators in Amsterdam. Or people that do, you know, similar kind of stuff to me. And little bubbles coming out of here. Yeah. Thanks, James. How are you doing? What is news? Can you like type us a quick what is happening in the ad world? What is happening in London? I'd love to know. London is just another city that I absolutely love. It's just so busy. And I was in Berlin once and there was this French lady who was staying in the Airbnb that we were staying in. And she said she missed Paris. But she loves Berlin, but she misses Paris and this rush that she used to get just using the metro system there and running for the train and knowing that there was one coming in 2 minutes, but still running and everybody else is running. And I was like, yeah, haven't really experienced that in Paris because I was, you know, a tourist. Wanted to walk a lot as well, but definitely in London, I've experienced that massively. Just seeing people run, seeing people just be, you know, eyes down, walk. It's intense. But there's definitely this amazing energy out there. I guess in those two cities. They're really big, just amazing. Imperial cities? Are they imperial? I don't know. They're very, very royal. I love them. Okay. Just adding a couple of little bubbles in places. Maybe I should do a little... What is that, you may ask? A little fin over here. That might be pretty good. Et voilà. See, when I say et voilà now, and Riza, the fact that you're in here, I'm like, am I even saying that right? I should just be like, great. Perfect. All the ad people here are becoming afraid of AI. Understandable. I think a lot of artists are beginning to also be like, interesting. What about a snorkel? Snorkel might be cool. Might be too late for that. I don't know. Just saw this and I was like, oh, could be a diver or something like that. There could be another submarine. Submarino. Yeah, there we go. Just popping out from behind the moray. Boop. It's my little quick trick that I always forget, but you just go tap, tap, kaboom, yeah, sure, but tap, tap, and then it goes to the brush, tap, tap, goes to the eraser. Ha! It's really irritating when you don't know that that's happening. Like, really irritating. Oh, man. AI, guys. I've been using a little bit of Notion's AI. It can be like brainstorm community engagement ideas. And it's just like, brainstorm this. It just gives you ideas. It's crazy. But yesterday, my friend and I were talking, and I was we're talking a long time. But one of the things he mentioned was this idea of blue ocean strategy. So a red ocean is a market where everyone's competing on the same thing. So like you're trying to get better quality, but somebody may always beat you in quality. You might, and then the other one is price. You're always trying to be cheaper than somebody else. So it's like, how do you win in this area? And when AI is concerned, people are going to get better at AI. People are going to make cheaper AI. Like, whew, there's going to be a lot of jobs just like, poof, gone. But a blue ocean is where there are no competitors. So the red ocean is because everyone's eating each other. There's lots of sharks in the ocean. Whereas a blue ocean is where there are no competitors. There are no sharks. So you can do whatever you want. And so you make this very unique space to live, thrive. And that challenged me a lot. Like, I can't compete on a lot of things, but where can I compete? Where is my blue ocean? So this is me blue oceaning right now. Like, artificial intelligence definitely can't do this live and talk. Not for the next couple of years anyway, and be entertaining. And have friends. Like, I don't know. So I'm working on that, thinking about this idea of where is my blue ocean? Where am I playing where nobody else can touch me just because it's almost impossible to reach me in my blue ocean? Obviously, you need people to be in your blue ocean to consume what you're doing or to bring value into other people's lives or businesses. But yeah, it's a very interesting idea. Okay, so we've got a couple of these things. Couple of the morays, the eels. Oh yeah. Maybe this guy can be behind a little bit too. A little bit of depth into the composition, which is always good. And yeah, let's put another one over here. like there. Like I forget to use my quick little shortcuts. It's kind of weird. I also had to like, sometimes I can't double tap, like to undo. Like there, so I've had to use my other hand or get used to pressing the actual undo button, which has been a little bit strange. I can put in another one here. Just guess, yeah, getting used to different ways of working. Maybe we should do another big fish. A big fish? But where? Where can I do a big fish? Maybe here. Something like this. That is an eye that's too big. Yeah. I like that. I like it. I like it. All right. Yeah, I like that, James. Like you can't actually watch the time lapse or, you know, the behind the scenes of an AI generated image. That is cool. So Reza and I are creating NFTs. What happens if you mint that, your creation process video? Because an AI can't do that. An AI generated can't do that, right? I mean, maybe it could. I mean, there is AI video, but the whole sketching part of it, like the fact that you can create a sketch and a finished image, like, woof, that's power. Right there, James, right there. I like that. I like it. It's like trying to stand out and be different from AI, you know? It's even the way you write, like you put in mistakes or you break the rules of language for it to make a little more sense or, you know, to throw in a little bit of humor there. I like that. I think it's a really good idea. Yeah. Time lapse would be good. Yeah. But man, I also, I'm curious to know, I don't actually know what I'm doing here. Just keep on doing the same thing over and over. That's a pretty interesting shape. There we go. I've tried to do a little bit of AI stuff, but I haven't really got into it. But I definitely feel like it's something that I need to learn how to do. So apparently, like, designers and creative people make way better AI prompt writers than non-designers, non-creatives, which is really interesting. It's like, if you're really good at creating, you're going to be able to use Photoshop and an iPad better than someone who's not really creative or not been an artist for a long time. So, yeah, I'm interested in using it as a tool, as an artist, as a creative, you know? I'm going to add a little bit of, I don't know, like see things. Maybe to make it a little bit like priestess-y, a little bit like holy, like the mermaid's father, Poseidon or mother. So it's not just all fun doodles, but you know, this also kind of looks like a mouth, which I really like. Okay, so there's quite a lot of stuff going on here, which is awesome. I wonder if I can do any kind of merging. I guess I can merge those two down. Is there anything that's overlapping? I don't think I can see much. So we could just merge it all. Flatten. There we go. Like, for example, like I would, I love drawing towers and castles, but like to do all the different layers of all the different castles and stuff like takes a long time. I just want to be like, make me a castle image with lots of different towers, or like a, you know, a Carcassonne, kind of a an old school city castle with lots of towers and stuff. Like, just do that for me and then I can work on top of that. That would be great. So that's where I kind of want to get to and be like, and also why I'm looking into processing and stuff. Like, yes, I want 20 birds here in this line or this line, but at different rotations and stuff. So maybe I could draw 20 birds and it selects random ones and colors them differently. So it's hand drawn, but there's different tools to speed up the workflow, you know? Stuff like that, stuff like that. Okay. Let's draw some of these trees, I reckon. Maybe they can be these cloudy type of trees. Oh yeah. Maybe. This one can be in front, I reckon. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna make them a little bit more like Marge Simpson, I reckon. So that one's pretty interesting. This one, not so much. So let's, whoa. And I'm drawing on the wrong layer. Damn. All right, take two. Let's go Marge Simpson. It's pretty interesting when you do things like by mistake, and then the next time you do them, it's a lot quicker. Or like the next day, it's just a lot quicker. You're like, oh, this took me like 3 hours to try to do. And the next day you rock up and you just do it in like half an hour. You're like, what? Why did it take me so long the other day? And then you realize, oh, it's because I was tired or because my mind wasn't sharp. It's pretty interesting. Fascinating. These can be called the Marge Simpson trees. I don't actually know if this is what Marge Simpson hair looks like. Let's have a quick look. Marge Simpson images. Yeah, like kind of. Okay, we can erase here. Sometimes I forget like where I'm erasing. I'm like, this layer, no, this layer. Okay, and then here. So tomorrow is the day that we get a massive tip in our garden, like a big ass container that sits outside our garden in the road, and we fill it up with trees and bushes and leaves and plants and stuff. And we're gonna borrow our neighbor's industrial military grade hedge cutter and maybe some other tools. It's gonna be epic. This one's in front. Is that possible for it to be in front? No, I don't think so. Let's merge these. Flatten. It's kind of weird right now, but let's do that, because I think that makes more sense where they're what are these called? Tree stumps? I actually don't know. They're not boughs, they're the base of the tree. The word has escaped me. Oh dear. Okay. And this one can just be over here. The base of a tree. If James went, cheers, bye. It's really good to have you here, James. I wish you could have heard that. You'll have to listen to the recording. Okay. This one can be in front, I reckon. As can this one. There we go. And this one can be at the back, maybe. Yeah, I reckon it could be at the back. Let's see what it looks like if it is. Something like that. So this one's in front, this one's in front. Or maybe this one's in the middle. Could that work? I mean, it could work. That could be kind of in the middle. Let's give it a go. So the fish's fin is on this side of the tree and that side of the tree. Yeah. And then we'll erase this part of the fin with a bigger eraser. And this one can be at the back. Something like that. Yes, it looks good. Well, we shall see how good it looks a bit later on, but I think for now it looks good. Okay, then this bird is going to be on top of everything. So just doing a bit of a raising there. This bird's going to be on top of everything. So we need to do some erasing here. Okay. That looks good. And then we can do some erasing here. It's all part of the same thing now. Okay. Okay, then we can do some eyes. Hey, Johan, or is it Johan? Oh, Johan. There's a fun there, so I reckon it's Dutch or something like Dutch. So I'm going for Johan. Hi. Is it Dutch? Can I say, hoe gaat het met jou? Or goedemorgen? I mean, with a second name like that, it could be Afrikaans as well. So it could be like, yeah, they're the same language, but how would I say hello in Afrikaans? It was also goedemorgen or goeiemorgen. That sounded strange. Okay. Goedemorgen, bro. Oh, it's Phyrexis. I did not know that that was your last name. Johan. Phyrexis. Ja, het gaat goed. En met jou? Ja, het gaat ook goed met mij. We hebben wat tuinwerk gedaan op het weekend. En vandaag en morgen gaan wij ook tuinwerk doen. Now you gotta rate me. How was my Dutch? My French was 7 out of 10. Reza gave me a 7 out of 10. How was that in terms of my Dutch pronunciation? Please let me know. A little bit. Yeah. I wonder, almost, but not yet. 6 out of 10. Oh, I got a better French score from Risa. Flip. Hey, Brandon. So Brandon Heim is my main zwager, which is my brother-in-law, everyone. Should definitely say hi to him. I call him Boots, and he calls me Boots too. And he's Uncle Brandy to my daughter. He is a graphic designer. I'm trying to tell him about NFTs and doing stuff. Might be listening to me, might be. But now he's checking out my stream, yeah. Yo, Boots. That's cool. All right. Okay. I always find it weird I'm going this way, but I can't see where I'm drawing because my hand is in the way. It's like I want to see where I'm drawing. It's always kind of weird. I guess I could, you know, turn the page around or something. But I like drawing this way. Maybe that's just like a little thing about doodling. It is what it is, you know? It is what it is. And there we can have like two different shades of blue or something like that. Okay, so the only thing that I haven't done is seaweed. And I'm wondering just how much seaweed I need to do. It's really just at the bottom here. I don't know, maybe there could be a little bit more. So I'll rub that out. Erase that. How are you doing, Boots? If you're still here. What's going on? How was work? Did you go into the office today? Or if you had a relaxing day at home? Tell us. So, my brother-in-law, Boots, graphic designer, also lives in Amsterdam with my wife's whole family, all living in Amsterdam now, or in the Netherlands, I should say. So this guy, I still really like this guy, so I want him to always be there. But maybe... Okay, let's rub out the important parts first. I think it could be cool if it went down here, like that. And then we rub this out. Yeah, something like that. Yeah, he's working from home. Phyrexis or Johan. Basically, why I wear this thing is that if I don't, like, I'll show you. It may work, it may not. Sometimes, especially in summer, like my hand gets hot and sweaty or it's dry or something. So I end up drawing and then I get stuck and I'm like, I can't move. And then I end up drawing these weird lines. It's like stuck, dish. Whereas with the glove, it's just way smoother. So apparently you're meant to draw, you know, like a portrait painter with your tablet up there or your, you know, whatever you're drawing on up there, not on the table. And you're not meant to press on it. You're meant to just like lightly draw, like hovering like a feather. I don't do that. I'm always leaning. So here I can just move really smoothly with this glove. So that's why I use it. The only reason why I use it. So yeah, hopefully that answers your question. And I think you can get them everywhere. But there is this Dutch company called Pen.tips. They are not sponsoring me. Oh, it's a little bit faded now. That make them. And they also make these cool pen nibs. I don't have any on me at the moment. But yeah, so it's a really cool brand. Everyone wants your attention. It's because you're so good looking, bro. They just want to be like looked at by you. Guys, my brother-in-law, I think from the age of 11, had a bigger beard and a bigger mustache than me. He's just really good looking. Like everyone just wants his attention. What more can I say, you know? Anyway. Family jealousies aside, let's continue with this little drawing. This all needs to go. All of it. Yeah, I think that's a pretty good balance. Well, except for here. Maybe we'll take this out as well. So some of it will be behind the submarine. Some of it will be in front. Something like that. Yeah. There we go. Yeah, you go blush, bro. You go blush. And here, let's put a little bit of the erase tool to use again. And over here. A little moray eel. I've really enjoyed these moray eels today. And I need to figure out what's going on here. So erase this, erase that. All of that. Check it out. Okay, you little guy, what's gonna happen with you? I'm gonna put you in front. Maybe put you in front here. And then at the back, you can, you know, almost like a clownfish, just poking in between the, whatever these things are, seaweed. Sometimes this kind of stuff can get confusing. There we go. I think that's it. And here, yeah, let's erase this. And erase this. No, let's keep that one. We'll erase the seaweed. Okay. So we've done quite a lot of work. Quite a lot of work. I wonder if I group these and flatten them, turn it off, turn this one off, and turn off this drawing guide, which tells me where my center and my image is. Yeah, so that's pretty much what I got at the moment. And it looks fairly busy down here, but at the top, not so much. They might be okay. Maybe I can draw a couple of shells or something like that. Maybe a couple of crabs could be cool. Let's try that. No idea how to draw crabs. Does that look like a crab? Something like that. Yeah, this is how we're drawing crabs today, everybody. Nope. Okay. Maybe, maybe not. I don't know. Might just be a little bit too detailed or something. So maybe what I do instead is I add a little bit of foliage here, you know, grass or something like that, just to give it a little bit of texture or detail, but not like really high detail or detail. Do not know how to explain that. There we go. Oh yeah, oh yeah. See, I think that looks a little bit better. Maybe even looks like this creature is bald, but you may not even see that it is a fish, in fact, with these fish lips and fins and stuff like that, and fins. Yeah, may not. This area all here, I reckon, will be black, and like a night sky. Ooh, there's a little bit that we need to fix. Sometimes I don't see these things until they're on the blockchain, but also at least until a little bit later. All right. I'm going to merge everything down now. Flatten them and reference this layer and do some coloring. Which is always a tricky part to know, like, where to start with the coloring. I guess we could start with blue. And the reason I go for jiggly color here, this brush, it's exactly the same, except this one, it doesn't have any, what is it called, stabilization. Whereas this one, it does. So you can see how, like, really, it bends nicely, basically. Whereas the jiggly color is far more like responsive to my hand. Let's clear that. Okay. And that means I can just, you know, color in or fill when I want to, rather than just relying on the fill tool the whole time. And yeah, Procreate have made, oh, I see, there's another little thing. Leaps of progress when it comes to their fill tool. I always preferred Procreate, Adobe Fresco's fill tool. I think I still might, but yeah, this one is now usable. Whereas before you had to like drag, and then you had to like figure out that there was something here that you could then use to continue filling. My old iPad has these scratch marks from this palette over here, this color swatch over here, just because of the amount of times I'd have to pull in a color to fill a particular space. Okay. And then, on top of this, let's duplicate this. And then I'm going to fill everything, because everything needs to have like a blue kind of a color underneath here. There was a place that I wanted to change. Quick little erase here. That's probably another place. I'm sure there was yet another place that needed some kind of attention. Maybe over here. Well, hopefully I find it again, if it indeed does need attention. Beep, boop, boop. There's a lot of filling that I need to do. There must be an easier way, surely. Like a lot easier way. There we go. I just saved myself like 4 hours of color filling. Wow. Wow. Oh, there's... No, I don't think that's a problem. Okay. Here, we'll add a little bit to here. Okay. I think that's good. Maybe we'll just add a little bit more here. That's going to be on top, I think, but we can just fill that if we need to. Okay. Now I can remove this for now, and I will put it back a little bit later, and then we can do a bunch of filling. So this, for me, this fish could be a goldfish, it could be an orangey fish, a peachy fish, you know? There we are, Riza, yes. I almost did that. It'd be really nice if like YouTube went bing or something when somebody sent a comment. Maybe it does, maybe it can, I don't know. Okay, I've got 5 more minutes. I'm not going to finish this, but I've really had fun today. Thanks for joining me. Continue filling. I'm going to do the body and the head as different things so that I can color them a little bit differently. Boop. Okay. And then I reckon the fins are next. And I might end up coloring in like this one in the middle slightly differently. Whoa. Calm down. For example. Okay. Move you up. I'll put a little bit more color here. Okay. Starting to come along. I reckon we can fill all of these fish with the same color. Gonna remove this one quickly. There we go. Continue filling. I'll often just forget like one or two particular fish. I think I've got all of those ones for now. Looks good. And then some orange. Dup, 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 dup. Dup, dup. Dup, 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 dup. Dup, 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 dup. See, like, this would be a cool place for AI to exist. Like, hey, AI, just, like, color all the fin colors orange. Thanks. It's still a little bit away from that. Ooh, that's a nice color. I like that. And, ooh, purple or green? 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 Yeah, we can change it a little later on if it needs to. And white for the eyes. There's quite a lot of whites that we need to fill in. I don't know who does that. Like, who actually wants to fill in all their edges? Like, I've never had a use case for this tool. To fill in all the edges, you know? Strange. Maybe not. Maybe that just needs a little bit more black. Okay. We're getting places. Oh, I can do these two, I reckon. Nope. Nope. Stop it. Okay. It's a little bit of black there that we can remove. And we can do some black now. I'll just do it on the same layer because most of the time I don't do much with eyeballs and the blacks and whites of eyeballs. Okay, it's starting to take a lot of shape now. Sometimes I look at like flat pieces and I'm like, oh, actually that looks really nice after going really heavy into gradienting and different like kind of textures and stuff. So I might try more flat stuff this year at some point. Just because it's quite simple and it makes it very fun, like very fun. Yeah. Okay. Seaweed, purple seaweed, pink seaweed. Most people would do seaweed green, I think. But pink, let's try pink. Lots of little bits here. blue at the bottom. Let's pop that there. Is this blue colored? It is. Okay. There was a little patch over here, which I needed to get. Okay. Then I guess we have some submarines that can be colored. Okay. Man, I like to make these maybe orange. Okay, and then I'll go back here and just do that, 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 that. Okay, we need a little bit of gray for the propeller and a little bit of black for the portals or the windows, whatever you might call them. Okay, lips. What's the time? Oof, it's past home time, basically. I'm gonna finish the coloring of the fish down here and then I'll call it a day. Okay. White, do you think that these things could be pearls that this fish dreamling is popping forth into the doodleverse? That could be a pretty cool thing. I like that. Okay, these fish, purple. Oof, yeah, that looks good. You can also be purple. So can you. And pink. Kind of messes over there. But over here, it could be pretty cool. Might need to change that later on. We shall see. Oh, this one's got its own lips. Maybe it should be its own kind of fish. Yeah, let's make it its own kind of fish. Let's cut you. Let's give you your own life. What color are you going to be? Why is that all pink? That's weird. What happened there? Interesting. Let's... quickly change you, cut you, and it's like I'm getting majorly distracted right now. Okay. Can we make you a green fish? We can make you a green fish. Ooh, with this kind of, yeah, look at those colors. I like those colors. Those are some good colors. Okay. And then maybe we can do the opposite for this fish. And her. Ooh, but she was a moonfish. But those colors are looking good. Okay. There's a little bit extra I need to put in over here. Pop it in there. And then we can do the eye. Another layer for the black. I think there could be some more stuff going on with the eye, maybe some clouds or something. This could end up being like the most detailed Dreamling piece out there. Okay. And then orange. It works quite nicely. And then a pink, a light pink. Yep. I'll just do this by myself. And this may end up changing. You never know. Okay, so that is where I've got to for today. Yeah, I think it's pretty cool. It's a very fun Dreamlings piece at the moment. Okay, maybe we just finish this off. No, not the whole thing, but just we put a little bit of, could keep that sand color. We could be like, cool, let's do the trees quickly. Just so that we can see what it all looks like, you know. Might have to put a bit of bark texture on these. It's probably a good idea for me to like do this and then have a look at it a bit later. It's also this to be added. And this one, we can change the color a little bit. So it's like that. Yeah. Okay. These little birdlings, let's make you a color. We can make you white for now. Yeah. With blue. Let's make it with blue. That could be pretty cool. Yeah. And yellow beaks. Okay. And then finally this area, I reckon it either could be green or this color. Because it's kind of like a fish or a crab or something like that. And then the background color is black. Okay, so that didn't take too much extra time. And there we have the beginnings of a Dreamlings piece. It's looking pretty cool. Really like these little guys, my moray eels. I really like these colors. And yeah, it's really a busy piece for a Dreamlings piece, which I haven't done in a little while. And maybe it's because I feel like, oh, I need to finish within an hour, hour and a half when I'm streaming. But really, this has taken a long time. And maybe because I've been talking a lot as well. So yeah, thank you so much for joining me. People, Riza, Boots, Forexus, James, anyone else that joined the stream, I really appreciate you guys joining. You guys are amazing. Thank you for the French and Dutch scores as well. And I will see you online, on Twitter, stuff like that. Now, I was going to do something at the end of the stream to have like an end screen, but I totally forgot about that. So I'm just gonna press stop streaming, bam, and press yes, and I'll see you guys soon.